Hello boys and girls and welcome. In this video I'm going to show you how to use the jump drive, which is these right here. It's extremely simple, but you know, if you don't know what you're doing it can be confusing. You're going to need one jump drive computer and then one jump drive module. And I'll tell you why later on in the video why you only need one each. So pretty much, you know, you just go to the shop and then go to ship and then just scroll down and it's at the bottom, jump drive computer and the jump drive module. You only need one of each, and I'll show you why as soon as you get back to my ship. Here's my two ships, that one I just shot at testing out different weapon combos and stuff. This ship is what we're going to use to show you the jump drive and how it works. That's my Mark 1, but technically it's Mark 4, but we're going to call it 1 since I couldn't find the other save. Because I want to save all my upgrades, like how I changed it. That one, I'm hauling out all the thrusters and all that, because so much has changed. So much has changed, I'm hollowing that out, weapons and everything, to redo them. Because now that so much has changed since the last time I played, let's get out of there. It needs to be all redone. So I'll redo the whole ship, but I don't have the other three versions because I never saved them. But I have this one saved just to reflect on my changes. Alright, first thing you want to do is get in your ship, go to build mode. And you can set it anywhere in the ship you want. We're going to go over here to this hollow space. And just simply set your computer down. Alright. And it's already selected, as you can see. It's the little orange box around it. But if you don't know how to select it, you just look at it and hit C. See, it's unselected, selected. Alright, and then you place one jump drive module beside it. Bam. You only need one. Because as in this current build, was a version 1807, I believe it is. No matter how many you add in, like I can add it, that's why I got 1998, or 99 counting this one, because I was testing, does more make it warp farther or charge up faster? No, it doesn't. As in this current build, more does not have any difference at all that I could tell. I timed it and I couldn't see any difference. Now, that's as in this video and this build, that's how it is. Now, I'm sure it's subjected to change in the future. But as in this making of this video, you only need one each, and that's it. Alright, now, let's get up here. Go to weapons. And then look for a jump drive computer. Bring it down here. Alright. See your little wheel here. Make sure it's highlighted on number one. And then you hold down the left click. And then continue to hold it down while it charges up. It takes ages for it to charge up. See the green there going away, the white's going around. It's slowly charging. It takes a while. And I've added in up to like 1,999 of them, and it has no difference. It doesn't speed up the charge time, nothing. So it takes a good minute. Still awesome though, nonetheless. But you gotta continue to hold your left mouse button. Almost the quarter of the way. And then once it's charged, it'll be fully green again. Bam, it's fully green again. And let's go to our map so we can show you where we are currently. See, we're above my Cyplex there. This is where we are, just above that. Alright. Directly on top of it. Alright. Now to warp, you just click the right button, and then you warp. It's like... You jumped. Now, we go back to our map. And see how far we jumped? It jumps you 8 blocks. Or sectors, not blocks. Sectors. You're at 1, 2, 3... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is where we were, and this is where we are. I mean, that's pretty cool, you know, you can jump that far, you know. And that's without the warp gates. If I ain't mistaken, I think the warp gates might jump you further. I was messing around with it, and it kind of wasn't working for me, but I'm going to continue to tinker around with that. Let's hit it again. We can go. Let's see if we can turn in another direction. You can continue to hold, like I said, the left mouse click, and you can continue to move around. as long as you're holding it. You can't let off of it. Now, if you do let off of it, the charging stops. As you can see. See, it charging, it stops. It doesn't continue. And it doesn't have to restart. So it's, if you have to fire, you can fire. Then hold the button again. Let it charge up some more. Okay, bam, it charged up. Maybe you have to let off. Fire again. Hold it again. Let it charge. That should be about the direction. Let's try this. But hopefully in the future, maybe it could be dependent on the size of the ship, how much power, how many of the modules you've got. You know, hopefully in the future, that's what it'll be. But as in this current build, one computer, one module, and that's it. Right click. And you can hit map and see where it puts you. Yep, puts us pretty much right back where we were. Because I turned around. I don't see my ships and stuff. Navigation, filter, ships. There they are, right below us. There's the one that's shot up, and then the other one's right there. I have all the view distance and stuff down, you know. And another cool thing is, see that right there? That is a black hole, and I think that's the only one we can see. Yeah. Okay, it's right there, so if we go to our map, hit P, and then we back all the way up. See, this is the black hole we see. So, if you drive into it, I think it shoots you over to there. Like, each one you go to, it'll shoot you around. That's what this purple is. Let's back out the galaxy here. You can see, you can go through the black holes, it'll port you around. Woo-hoo. But I love this new map system. It's awesome. It just shows you how many damn stars. Each one of those white dots are stars. Let's zoom back into our system here. Okay, this is our system. It's highlighted pink because they captured it, but you got a star, then you got planets around it, as you can see, the planets here. And then it shows you space stations, and it'll show you the shop in here. It's way down here. But that's a look at the warp drives, and hopefully it helped out somebody who it confused, like it did me at first, but I caught on quickly. And as always, don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe.